the natives used the ash to add flavor. So they could, it could be like cedar ash, it could be juniper ash. Okay, so today I am going to be doing a Hopi stew with blue corn dumplings. I chose to take these two recipes from two different tribes just to kind of learn more about them. The Hopi one comes from this cookbook. It's The Hopi Cookery by Juanita Tiger Cavena. I believe she was part of the Creek tribe but married into the Hopi tribe based in Arizona. A little bit about the Hopis. Hopi actually translates into the behaving or the peaceful people versus, let's say, like warring native tribes. And so they're kind of known for that. They were Pueblo descendants. So I have more kind of recent history about the Hopi tribe. And that is something that I also just want to learn more about. Like a lot of native reservations, some areas can be very secluded. There's also on reservations a lot of poverty, there's a lot of alcoholism. They're not always the happiest of places because a lot of these reservations, they're very secluded. You can drive miles and miles and there'll be like one shop here and one shop there, and there's not a lot of resources and access. And a lot of these places, they're not stable. A lot of these nations, they're not stable financially either. They should be getting help from the government. I think a lot of it is put on the back seat. And so from 1961 to 1964, the Hopis leased to the US government bits of land to allow companies to come in and dig for oil. We know from present history that there are pipelines that are being built through the US and also through Canada as well. And pipelines in general, what we know about them is they usually leak. And that is, you know, that is happening right now. So on native land, which is, you know, always, yeah, 50% unemployment on the Hopi reservation. So it's gonna be a lot of people without jobs. That's gonna be a lot of people that are gonna get sad. They're not going to really get the help that they need. And of course, you even like you hear today, there's like arsenic in the drinking water of native reservations. They don't have enough money to fix it, and they should, because they are part of America. And what I have paired the Hopi stew with is actually interesting because I did it by accident, but I found this recipe for Navajo blue dumplings. And the reason I liked it was because they mixed juniper ash, which I had such a hard time finding in London, but I ended up going to a cemetery and then afterwards going to a park to try and burn off the ashes. But what culinary ashes are used for, ash cooking is something that is very new and unique to me. Basically, the natives use the ash to add flavor. So they could, it could be like cedar ash, it could be juniper ash to add flavor, but it also adds color. So it kind of makes the blue a little bit more deep in something like blue corn dumplings. In addition, burning the ash, there's actually a lot of like trace minerals in there, like calcium and whatnot. And it really adds to the nutrition of a dish when you mix in the ashes. So yeah, those are the two that I have today. What I didn't know before I made this pairing was that the Hopis in Arizona have this long history with the Navajo Indians, which are the second largest tribe in the US over land. But to talk about the Navajo, so second largest nation to the Cherokee Indians, they are originally from, I guess, Canada and Alaska, and now settle in southwestern United States and Arizona and places like New Mexico. They are someone who took the long walk, so not the Trail of Tears, but something that they call the long walk, 1864. To an internment camp in New Mexico. And that is when their people were moved from their lands, had to walk 300 miles. During this walk, a lot of the natives died. There wasn't adequate food, there wasn't, you know, adequate shelter. But yeah, it was during a time period where it was like the Indian problem, where, you know, no matter where you move them, you still have Native Americans on American land. And so they were really trying to exterminate them group-wise, whether through killing or just moving them to another place where they, you know, can't really access their culture and food and land and whatnot. This place was screwed up in many ways, not just for the aforementioned thoughts, but the US government would be putting in warring tribes in the same place. So there were issues there as well. So it's not recent history, but I would say even today, reading about Native Americans today, it's one of these really screwed up things where to be considered a tribe, you need to prove to the US government that you have an independent, that you have your own language and that you have your own culture. And those things seem like, okay, easy to prove, but it wasn't really until like the 1980s, it was like 1978 before the US had the Native American, I think it was called the Religious Freedom Act. Because prior to that, the natives couldn't teach their own language, like in their own schools, on their reservations, and they couldn't really do ceremonies, like the religious ceremonies that they would normally do out in the open. And so it's like one of these really weird things, because for the past like 100, 150 years or so, you weren't allowed to be yourself. You weren't allowed to exercise your culture and your language. And now it's like to qualify to be a tribe, to get, you know, certain aids or whatnot, like now you have to show that, you know, you have a language and you have a culture. And so it's like this consistent mind-boggling thing. So yeah, that's a Hopi stew and blue corn dumplings for you. I will say that in this recipe, in the Hopi recipe book, they do use ground meat, because I personally do not eat meat. I'm just going to substitute it for meat crumbles. But if you are somebody that does, feel free to follow right along with the recipe. And yeah, it's really delicious. Everything's really colorful. So I hope you guys all enjoy. So I picked a pretty big bag of juniper branches, and man, were they spiky. And I would say don't try this at home unless you have a grill, an outdoor grill outside. It's a little too dangerous. The whole bag yielded about 2 tablespoons of ash, which I think maybe just wasn't enough, so maybe omit that. So after you have that, or have done that, put that aside, and we'll start with the stew. So I have 3/4 cup of lentils along with 2 cups of mushroom broth. Recipe is going to be down below, but this is going to be my substitute for the ground meat. And then in go the fresh corn as well as the squash. And the flavors are amazing because you get that nice savory base from the stock and then the sweetness from the corn and the squash. So bring that stew up to a boil and then lower it and cook it for 15 minutes. Now, meanwhile, we're gonna deal with this ash. So you're supposed to kind of do this with equal amounts of juniper ash and water, but I will do it with what I have. And I'm just mixing the ash with a little bit of boiling water, and I'm cooking it a little bit just to get all of the flavor and everything else out, and then I'm going to strain it out and use it for my blue corn dumplings.
So these dumplings are just a mixture of water and blue cornmeal. So I have 1 cup of finely ground blue cornmeal, and I'm going to mix it with 2/3 of a cup of that juniper water, and then also 1/2 cup of normal water, just to bring the dough together. It's a good idea to get your hands in there and see when you can actually form a patty, because after that, this dough is good to go. So what I have here is 1 tablespoon of finely ground cornmeal that I'm just mixing with a little bit of water to thicken up the stew. If you guys watch the Three Sisters stew, we thickened it up the same way. You don't need cornstarch or flour or anything. Just keep it to cornmeal, since this whole thing is a corn stew. So get that in there and then cook it for about a minute or so until the stew thickens, and then drop those blue dumplings right on top. So put a cover on this. It could not be any more simple, and cook it for an additional 10 minutes. So it was 15 minutes initially for the stew, 10 minutes for the dumplings, and then afterwards, sprinkle some parsley over and you can serve it. I'll tell you all, I am in love with these Native American stews right now, because I usually don't make a lot of soups or stews, but with such simple ingredients, I get so much flavor from this. And the dumplings make this kind of really nice and hearty. You get really quite nice and full from this stew. Anyways, I hope you all have been enjoying this Native American series for Native American Heritage Month. As usual, if you want to see more recipes like this, remember to hit that like and subscribe button, and I will see you guys all again next time. Bye!